Hello. In this video, let's talk about one of the important feature in developer perspective in SQL Server 2019. Approximate count distinct function. As a SQL developer, there are many cases where we have identified how many distinct values are there on a particular table. If the table is lightweight, then it is very easy to get a result. If the table is little medium weight, then it takes a considerable amount of time to return the result. But if the table is bit heavy weight, which is having million records or hundreds of millions or billion records, then it's very difficult to get this value in the SQL Server. But in 2019, Microsoft has introduced a built-in function to identify distinct values, approximate distinct values on a particular table. See, this is suitable when you have a more number of records in a table. If you have less than 10 or less than 100, then you can go with a distinct normal function in a SQL Server. So whatever the behavior you are getting here, you can achieve the same behavior through the earlier count and distinct functions as well. But 2019, you have a default function that gives a really good performance because it's a system built-in function. In that earlier scenario, you need to use two functions. Now here it's only one function. So let's quickly go to the SQL Server Management Studio of 2019 and let's see practically how to work with this. So first of all, so before practicing or before seeing that function in SQL Server 2019, let's check the compatibility level of a SQL Server database. So why? Because so that database compatibility level might have set to the older version, then this function won't work. How to check the database compatibility level? First of all, any database. So select any of the database. So I'm going to select AdventureWorks 2019. Okay. So right click on AdventureWorks 2019. Any database, right click on it and click on properties. So once you click on properties, hope you know that you will get these kind of options. Okay. The first tab is general tab where you can see collation and so on. Okay, what is the size of the database and how much space available, number of users, you can see it. Okay, and who is the owner also, you can see it. Now, you have a second option, files, file groups, and next one is options. Let's click on options. So, once you click on options, you get an option to see what is the compatibility level of the database. So, the first one is collation, recovery model, simple, that is fine, and the compatibility level. So, SQL Server 2019, it's in the bracket 150. So if you want to use SQL 2019 features, then you have to set the compatibility level to that particular version. See, by any chance, if the compatibility level set to 2008 or 2012 or 2014, 2016, 2017 and 2019. See, we have a backward compatibility. See, you can select 2008 and you can run the queries which are compatible to 2008. So if you select 2008 and if you try to use new features of 2019, obviously yes, it won't work. Okay, let's check it first of all before you run anything on 2019 features. Okay, anyway, my version compatibility is set to 2019 only, nothing to worry, I can do it. So let me check for other database. So let's select on AdventureWorks Data Warehouse 2019, click on properties. Okay, so click on options. Yeah, if you see the option here, by default it's set to 2017 140. Okay, so here I need to change it to 2019 and click on OK. So let's click on OK. Now, what are all the new features of 2019? I can use it. Why? Because my database is compatible to 2019 now. So now let's quickly come here and a new query. So let's take any of the table here. So I have a I'll take the one table from sales schema, sales order detail. So let me see what is the row count here. Yeah, I can see 121,000 records I have. Almost it executed in less than a second actually. It might have took around some 300-400 milliseconds. Since the database is designed in such manner with all primary key, foreign key indexed and all, so the performance of the database was little great actually. Okay, now, so now I want to identify, so what are all the distinct products on this table actually. So if I want to see how many distinct products are there in this table, ideally in the previous version of SQL Server, I used to write like this. Let me put select star from sales dot, I used to put, but since I'm using the AdventureWorks, so as it's been developed by the Microsoft for our practice purpose, it was indexed and it was normalized and it was checked in all the perspectives. Okay, that's the reason why the queries might be running very faster when you compare with your original databases. Okay, so the reason is, so when I run count distinct or approximate count distinct, I may not see much time difference. Why? Because the database itself is pre-indexed, pre-normalized. Okay, so now let's see, select count of distinct distinct product ID. I want to see how many distinct products have been sold in this table actually. Okay, this is how I used to identify in the previous version of SQL Server. Okay, so since the number of rows are also a little minimal and I have in pre-indexed database, that is the reason why I got the result in less than a second and the result is 266. So the similar result I can achieve by running that select. I don't need to run. If you see here, I have used count and distinct both. Now if I go for the 2019 features, I can directly run with a one built-in function. So even this also results might come less than a second. Okay, but the easiest on single function is, so approximate count distinct. Okay, so you can, let us see, let me put it here. Once I hover it here, you can see some information. It's a built-in function, so approx underscore count underscore distinct, it within this it was expecting an expression and it is returning a big integer. Okay, so let's open the bracket. And what column do you want to identify that? So put it as product ID. Okay, so it was telling us approximate actually. Why? Because so this stats from a statistical tables, not directly from a table. Okay, so now if I run it, even this also results also might come less than a second. But when you really apply the same different functions on the real database with huge number of records, you will see a difference in the timing actually. And the number value might differ here. Okay, there you got it as 266, here 263. I need to update the statistics, then only I can achieve this original 266, because that is the reason why. So Microsoft itself named that as a approximate count distinct actually. Okay, so once you update the statistics, once you update the statistics of the database, then there are chances of matching both the values. So that's how I'm going to use approximate count distinct function in SQL 2019. This is one of the new feature got introduced in 2019 for the developer perspective. So there are many other features have been introduced in terms of DBA, in terms of developer, in terms of expansion like a big data clusters and all. There are many are there. So in the next video, we'll talk about Scalar, UDF, inlining and light query processing. And there are a couple of vulnerability assessments and all. We'll talk about it. So that's it. So thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please drop your question in the comment section. I'll try to answer as soon as possible. That's it. Thank you for watching.